Meanwhile, the lawyers representing the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, in an election petition filed against her have clashed with the lawyers of her opponent, Salamu Musumba, after another application was filed in court seeking permission from the court to serve Kadaga. Let's see what happened.
Forum for Democratic Change Vice Chairperson for Eastern Region, Salam Musumba, through her lawyer John Isavirie of Isavirie & Company Advocates, filed another application before the Deputy Registrar, Fred Waninda, at the Jinja High Court on Wednesday, seeking to get permission to serve Kadaga the main election petition. The two contested for the Kamuli Woman MP seat in January, where Kadaga was declared winner and Musumba challenged the victory in courts of law. Musumba's lawyers have for the last 1 month failed to serve Kadaga the election petition, leading Musumba to file another application seeking to serve Kadaga the main petition. However, Kadaga's lawyers, led by John Mary Mujisha of Mujisha and Company Advocates and Emma Opio of Okua and Associated Advocates, argued that Musumba's application was overtaken by events.
For the petitioner to now want to seek to serve the petition that the respondent has, that the speaker has, we believe is actually a wastage of court's time. And is delaying the respondent from accessing her justice because we are wasting a lot of time with applications.
Opio said that their contention was that Musumba's application is an abuse of court process for reasons that include that Kadaga, who is the respondent in the main election petition, upon knowing of a purported election petition, instructed her lawyers to go to Jinja High Court and receive the petition and has already answered the petitioner, who is Musumba.
I want to seek to serve the petition that the respondent has, that the speaker has, we believe is actually a wastage of court's time. And is delaying the respondent from accessing her justice because we are wasting a lot of time with applications. A formal letter was written to the Registrar of Jinja High Court seeking the indulgence of whether there was a petition against the Speaker. And the Registrar duly responded and said, there is this document against you. Come and pick it. So if you're going to say that we jumped court process, the court process was as regards timelines. The timelines were passing and the respondent was waiting. So what the respondent did was prudent to find out what was in court against her.
He said that since they served their answer to the petition, they requested the court to proceed with the ruling of the main gist of the application, which is challenging the election of Kadaga, adding that they want to deal with the main petition rather than keeping on playing games with other applications.
We tried to serve them, but that is on court record as regards the service on them. But we are going to serve them as directed by court and rendering this whole application moot, an academic affair. And then we can move to the main gist of the application, which is challenging the election of the Right Honourable Speaker. We want to deal with that and move away, rather than keep on playing games with an application here and there.
Musumba's lawyer, Isavirie, says that in respect to a response that had just been served to him by Mujisha, one of Kadaga's lawyers, he requested for some time in order to reply to it.
This court cannot be allowed to open the world whose chest.
So I let you clear.
Yes, my lord.
You cannot perpetuate
illegality.
I've picked that point.
Yes, and the matter, my lord, it's a waste of time.
While in court, Isavirie said that they did file the application as an ex parte application, but he was surprised that the application had suddenly become inter parties. However, Fred Waninda, the deputy registrar at the Jinja High Court, adjourned the case to April 21st, 2021. This story was compiled by Donald Kiria for the news in Jinja City.